Hello and welcome back to Exothermic Plays Games. I'm Exothermic and the date today is Sunday, May 12th, 2024. I've been doing a countdown of my favorite video games of all time through each day of the year, and coming in at number 234 is Castle Crashers. Castle Crashers is the greatest thing to emerge from the Xbox Live Arcade. Developed by Behemoth Studios, which was spearheaded by visual artist Dan Paladin, which I today learned is not a pseudonym, it is in fact his real name, and Tom Fulp. If you're unfamiliar with Tom Fulp, he was the founder of Newgrounds and is basically the reason any of the Flash games on my list were able to come to fruition and exist. The game itself is an arcade-style beat-em-up where you play mostly as knights with different spell casting available. In addition to the knights you have access to at the start of the game, you can unlock a ton of other playable characters, such as many of the enemies you fight against, through story progression on varying difficulties, or with specific other characters. Journey through a ludicrous story filled with cheap humor and lowbrow gags. It's great. Your character has light attacks and heavy attacks that can be chained together, and also aerial attacks for both. Most characters handle that aspect of the game the same, but that's where the similarities end. Each character has a unique spell that they can cast. For example, here you see me playing as the Fire Knight, so I can shoot fireballs or giant explosions right in front of me. There's also items you'll collect that you can use, including a bow and arrow for non-magic ranged combat, or bombs. The game's loaded with collectibles. Starting with equipment, you can find weapons in a wide variety of ways. Some are purely story-driven, others you just buy in a store, and some require some exploration to find. Regardless, you can visit the blacksmith to equip any weapon you've already found on any of your characters, provided the character you're currently playing is high enough level to do so. The different weapons modify stats, or sometimes have other bonuses that are displayed at the blacksmith. In addition to weapons, you can collect pets. This was one of my favorite aspects of the game, and one of great contention amongst me and my brothers. Similarly to weapons, some pets were found through progression of the story, bought in the store, or had to be searched for or unlocked in some other special ways. At the same zone as the blacksmith, there's a big ark, and you can go inside to swap out your pets and find out what each one does. Every pet offers a unique bonus. Some are passive, and others show up as more direct involvement from the pet, such as the little ram floating that headbutts your enemies for you. The game's a lot of fun already as a single-player experience, but where it really shines is couch co-op. If you're looking for stupid, fun couch co-op, then look no further! Each player picks a different character, and tally-ho, you're killing stuff! It's always fun to just beat stuff up and have a bunch of laughs, but what puts Castle Crashers ahead of the curve is the amount of things you can't share with your friends. Players must pick different characters from one another, and you also can't have the same pets. At least in my household growing up, this caused a lot of arguments and fighting over who gets what. Oh, don't worry, we didn't physically hurt each other, at least not over Castle Crashers. There's a Colosseum that's just a free-for-all brawl to the death. It's perfect for resolving disputes such as who gets the giraffe. Once we get all of the arguments out of the way and start adventuring, the game is just smooth sailing. Most of the combat is the same as I described, but when you get killed by an enemy, one of your teammates can perform CPR to bring you back to life, making challenging content just that much more fun. There's games I'd consider objectively better than Castle Crashers, as evidenced by its ranking, and the single player lacks some of the best moments that the multiplayer provides, but few can capture the simplicity and lightning in a bottle that the couch co-op experience provides. Join me tomorrow as I talk about the 233rd game on my list where I get my ass kicked by my dad.
Again, also just in the game. It wasn't, you know, it was, he's good.